三宝。
Three treasures for new now receivers。
他人的一生中有许多值得庆贺的事情，但却有更多无价且必须要全力以赴来追求的东西。
There are many things in life worth celebrating. However, there are even more priceless things worth pursuing with all our efforts.
2500多年前，当释迦牟尼佛仍是王子时，亲眼目睹了人世间之生老病死，他告诉自己一定要找到一条永恒之路，于是他放弃了王位及荣华富贵，四处去找寻名师及拥有解脱的法门。后来燃灯古佛为他受记，最后他修成了正果，也留下了许多的经典，引导众生开悟正果。
About 2500 years ago, when Shakyamuni Buddha was still a prince, he witnessed the four sufferings of life, birth, old age, sickness and death. He told himself, I've got to find the way that leads to eternity. Thus,He gave up his throne and fortune in search for an enlightening master and the way to eternal liberation. Later, he was initiated by Dipankara Buddha and eventually reached Buddhahood. Shakyamuni Buddha's teachings were collected by his disciples as sutras.The large collection of sutras that continue to guide sentient beings even till this day.
在一般人的思维里，极有价值、罕有又很不容易得到的东西，而且是人类所一直在追求的，我们才会称之为宝。今天您在上天的恩典及诸佛菩萨的祝福下求了道，得了三宝。这道就是当初佛陀及无往经来的修行者宗教家倾一生之力所追寻的永恒之路。过去因为天时位置，道是单传独授，得道者稀，修行者常有看破铁鞋无觅处之憾。如今上天慈悲大开普渡，得道者众，求道者可说是得来全不费功夫。虽然得道容易，也是自己累世佛缘根基深厚，祖上有德所致，所以当您求完道时，大家都给您道喜。
Generally, we call a precious, valuable, and rare item which is highly sought after as a treasure. Today, because of the grace of heaven and the blessings from all Buddhas and Bodhisattvas,You have received Dao and the three treasures. Dao is the way to eternity that Shakyamuni Buddha, countless cultivators, and religious people have been searching all their lives. Before 1930, Dao was transmitted on a one-to-one basis.An enlightening master could only transmit Dao to a well-qualified individual because the timing for universal Dao transmission was not ripe. The number of people receiving Dao were scarce due to the lack of opportunity to meet with an enlightening master and receive Dao. What a handy! Because of the grace of heaven, now is the time for universal Tao transmission, and therefore, many people had the opportunity to receive Tao. Although it may seem relatively easy to receive Tao, receiving Tao is actually based on your affinity with Buddhas, your deep spiritual foundation, and the beneficence of your ancestors. Thus, after you had received Tao, everybody would express their heartfelt joy and congratulate you.
照三宝来修行的话，可以帮助我们。第一，跳脱生死轮回；第二，净化我们的业力，改变命运；最后，返回天上的故家乡。
Practicing these three treasures can truly help us in the following ways. One.Transcending the cycle of life and death. 2. Cleansing our karma, changing our destiny, and eventually returning to our heavenly home.
一般的人由于业力的牵引，不得不再苦来到这世界上，每来一次就会造些业，漫漫的人生路上总是有着诸多的不如意、抱怨、忧愁、烦恼、病痛等。面对命运的枷锁与生死的轮回，却不知所措，更无法跳脱出来，实属无奈。
Because most people's destiny are led by their karma, they have to go through the cycle of life.And death repeatedly without choice. Each cycle of life and death would accumulate some karma, good and bad. Therefore, their long journey of life would be filled with different kinds of complaints, worries, annoyances, sickness, and sufferings. Life's journey is never what we expected.Most people are imprisoned by fate and trapped in the cycle of life and death. They feel helpless because they failed to find a way to become liberated.
我们人的身体只是灵性暂时居住的房子。当生命旅程结束时，灵性会脱离身体进入另外一个世界，而求道时得到的三宝就是回天的凭证，这也是人生中最重要的一件事。以下是像是需要您放在心上的，以不要忘记三宝，也不可以泄露三宝。二不反造爱德，三多了愿，多行功立德，如此我们才可以回天上的故家乡。
Our physical body is a temporary home for our soul. When the journey of our life comes to an end, our soul will leave the body and enter another world.The three treasures you have received are the token for returning to the heavenly home. They are the most important things in our lives. The following are the three main points that you need to keep in mind. 1. Do not forget and disclose the three treasures. 2. Do not do anything illegal, immoral,or harmful to yourself and others. 3. Do as much as you can to fulfill your vows and accumulate merits and virtues. By following these three points, you will be able to return to the heavenly home.
现在让我们来简单地介绍一下三宝。
Now, let us briefly introduce the three treasures.
第一宝，玄关窍，灵性进出的门户。
The first treasure, heavenly portal, the main gate to our true nature / true self.
在庄严神圣的修道仪式中，便传师在我们的玄关窍这么一点，点燃了自信之光明。当下玄关窍立刻现出了如同绿豆大小般之佛光。我们可以看一下各宗教圣人的画像，每位圣人之头骨都有一个光圈，此光乃是自信之光。借着后续的修行及行功立德，此佛光会逐渐扩大，最后就像各教圣人的光圈一样地光亮圆满，展现出来的智慧及德行随着因缘愿力而自处利益众生。
During the solemn holy now receiving ceremony, now transmitting Master want at our heavenly portal to illuminate the light of our true nature. A small halo will radiate from the heavenly portal immediately afterwards. If we look at the portraits of the saints from different religions,We will see that they all had one thing in common, which is the halo behind each saint's head. The halo is the light emitted from the true nature. The halo will expand in accordance with our cultivation and accumulation of merits and virtues. Eventually,Our halos can be as round and bright as the halos of the saints. Then, the wisdom and virtue we exhibit will accompany our vows and affinities to benefit all mankind.
玄关是一个正门，也是修心的下手处。行住坐卧之中，常收束身心。从玄关发出之念头都是正念，慈悲心、喜舍心、智慧心，心提心念在玄关，在用玄关去听、去看、去应对一切事物，便能与佛菩萨以心应心。
Heavenly portal is the main gate of our bodyIt is also the starting point for us to cultivate our heart. Every day we need to manage our mind and body properly. Each and every thought from the main gate is righteous because it is full of mercy, compassion, joy, giving, and wisdom.Focus our mind slightly on the heavenly portal and use this focused attention to listen, look, and deal with everyday matters. Then, we can unify our heart with the heart of Buddha and Bodhisattvas.
我们求道是了解我们有个真主人，真主人也是住在我们的家里面，每间房子都会有主人的房间，主人有主人该睡的地方，客人有客人该睡的地方，这不能错乱的。
Receiving those to help us recognize the true master. Our body is like a house. Now,We know that this true master lives in our house. Every house has a master bedroom. The master bedroom is the room where the master sleeps and guests have to sleep in the guest rooms because only the master should sleep in the master bedroom. This arrangement should not be altered in any way.
各教界 经典，也有关于玄关窍之论述。子曰，谁能徒步由浦河莫由斯道也，每个人要走出房子都要经由门户。的肉体由如果宅，修行者欲跳脱此果宅之束缚，何不走这一条光明大道呢？
The classics, sutras, and scriptures of different religions all contain descriptions of the heavenly portal. Confucius said, who can go out without using the door, so why doesn't he anybody follow the way? Now everyone gets out of the house through the door.The physical body is like a burning house. A cultivator needs to take the correct and bright path in order to break free from the confinement of the burning house.
圣经里也提到
Testimonies of the heavenly portal can also be found in the Holy Bible.
眼睛就是身上的灯。
The light of the body is the eye.
你的眼睛若了亮，全身又光明。你的眼睛若昏花，全身又黑暗。你里头的光若黑暗了，那黑暗是何等大呢？
The lamp of the body is the eye.If therefore thine eye be single, thy whole body shall be full of light.
马太福音
Matthew 6:22 But if thine eye be evil, thy whole body shall be full of darkness. If therefore the light that is in thee be darkness, how great is the darkness?
马太福音
Matthew 6:23 The lamp of thy body is thine eye. When thine eye is single, thy whole body also is full of light. But when it is evil, thy body also is full of darkness.
路加福音
Luke 11:34
你岂有一只眼睛入永生，倘如有两只眼泪丢在地狱的火里边。
It is good for me to enter into life with one eye, rather than having two eyes to be cast into the hell of fire.
马太福音
Matthew 18:9
试问是用左眼还是右眼上天堂进入永生呢？肉眼早晚会毁坏的，如何使人上天堂呢？
After reading the above verses, some questions may arise. For example, should we enter heaven and attain eternal life through the left eye or right eye, since the eyes of this physical body will deteriorate one day? How can they help us return to heaven?
玄关窍已被解开后，好好地修持，久而久之，身体内外真的会光明，连毛细孔都会发出光来，尤其是真修持练得到清闲前，只是我们的肉眼看不到而已。点
Once the heavenly port is opened, if we cultivate God sincerely for some period of time,Then both our internal and external body parts, including our pores, will be luminous. This is true for all members who have cultivated sincerely and truthfully. However, the light or halo emitted from the body cannot be seen with the naked eye.
佛经也提及，无有正法眼藏。涅槃妙心不立文字，教外别传解释问， 佛陀所言之正法是常在作演或有演呢，或是第三之真理演修或造的人就很清楚答案了。
In the Buddhist Sutra, Sakyamuni Buddha also said, there is the true Dharma in my eye, there is no form, there is no word for it. So where is the true Dharma hidden? Is it hidden inside the left eye or right eye, or is this Dharma hidden inside the third eye, the eye of the truth? The answer is very clear for any Tao receiver.
儒家所说的君子圣其如也，指的也是我们在自性佛性是如一无二的，来自上天，要善加戒慎保护，莫让他受到污染。慎独的功夫，简单的说，就是存好心，说好话，做好事，以及诸恶莫作，众善奉行，精进永恒地藏道前进。
In the Confucian classics, a noble person needs to be cautious with the one. The one is referring to our true nature or true self, which is unique and came from heaven.We need to be cautious by protecting it from pollution. In other words, we need to keep a good heart, say good words, and do good things. We need to do all good deeds continuously with all our efforts.
一个人